Rain Queens of South Africa. This is a story about women who ruled the Limpopo province of South Africa, the only matrilineal monarchy in the world. I introduce to you the Modjadjis, or the Rain Queens of Balobedu. There are two stories that tell the origins of the Rain Queens. The first is in the 16th century. The chief of Monomotapa was told his daughter, Dzugundini, could gain rainmaking skills if he impregnated her. The second story is that Dzugundini was impregnated by her brother, but was able to flee to the Sotho region of South Africa. Dzugundini eventually went on to find and found the Balobedu kingdom of South Africa, which at the time had a male ruler. As warfare increased, so did problems with the Balobedu kingdom. The Mogudo, or the male ruler of Balobedu, wanted to restore peace within his kingdom, so he impregnated his daughter. The child was the first Modjadji, or Rain Queen. The succession of Rain Queens are as follows. The first Rain Queen was Maselekwane Modjadji, who ruled from 1800 to 1854. Rain Queen the second was Masalanabo Modjadji, who ruled from 1854 to 1894. Rain Queen the third was Kesetoane Modjadji, who ruled from 1895 to 1959. Rain Queen the fourth was Makoma Modjadji, who ruled from 1959 to 1980. Rain Queen the fifth was Makope Modjadji, who ruled from 1981 to 2001. Rain Queen the sixth was Makobo Modjadji, who ruled from 2003 to 2005. From 2007 to 2018, Prince Regent Limpopo da Modjadji led the Balobedu kingdom. During the reign of the second Rain Queen, the Balobedu kingdom was overrun by the majority white South African military. Under the oppression of the apartheid, the power and influence of the Rain Queen was weakened. During the 1990s, after apartheid ended, the Rain Queen's power and influence was restored. Currently, no Rain Queen sits upon the throne, but in 2023, Princess Masalanabo will be crowned Rain Queen the 7th Modjadji Masalanabo on her 18th birthday. It was customary for the Rain Queen to never appear in public. She would communicate to her people through her royal counselors. The Rain Queen does not marry but is allowed to have a romantic partner. To ensure the loyalty of the kingdom, the Rain Queen would take wives from the various nobles of the kingdom. The wives would become royal servants or even romantic partners for some of the men in the kingdom. The lore and the prominence of the Rain Queen was abundant within South Africa. Even the mighty Shaka Zulu respected the lore of the Rain Queen. To help reinforce the Rain Queen's power, every November a rainmaking ceremony was held within the kingdom. It is said the power of the Rain Queen keeps the cycad tree in abundance and a rain belt within the gardens that surround the royal compound. Since the Rain Queen will only be a woman, when she does mate, she will usually mate with the man chosen by her royal council. The eldest daughter of the Rain Queen is usually the successor to the throne. If the Rain Queen has no daughters, or other circumstances prevent the queen's eldest daughter to ascend to the throne, the woman who is the closest in relation to the queen becomes the next Rain Queen. In the past, it was custom for the Rain Queen to commit ritual suicide so her daughter can ascend to the throne. Today, they no longer continue that custom. The influence of the Rain Queen spread to Western culture. Marvel's character Storm of the X-Men was taken from the Rain Queen. Even the book She, A History of Adventure, written by R.H. Ryder Haggard, was inspired by the Rain Queens, specifically the second Rain Queen, Masalanabo I, Modjadji. There seems to be a continued misconception that women can't rule, and specifically black women are not rulers of kingdoms. The Rain Queens are the latest example of women rulers I have presented to you. They are the first and only all-women-led monarchy in the world. To all six of the previous Rain Queens and to the upcoming seventh Rain Queen, we're proud. Stand on your shoulders. For more information, please visit my website at www.ontheshoulders1.com or www.ontheshoulders.org to learn more about my On the Shoulders of Giants book series and the On the Shoulders of Giants online course.